it for recreational purposes, but we do not own the rights to it. And this is Pastor John B. Key, standing in need of prayer. Standing in need. Y'all want to go back and look that up? You're more than welcome to. But that's Pastor Key, Pastor John B. Key. We thank the Lord for allowing us to wake up today. Thank the Lord for everything that He has done for us, keeping the roof over our heads, clothes on our back, keeping us in our right frame of mind, letting us see another day that was not promised to us, showing us another beautiful day, even allowing us to see a brand new day that He didn't even recycle on yesterday. He didn't give us yesterday and give it back to us again today. He gave us a brand new day, and I'm grateful to God for allowing me to be woke up one more time. He didn't have to do it, but I'm grateful to God that He did. I'm grateful to God for the many blessings that He has given out. He has given. I thank the Lord for everything that He has done. And you know, we always give God His credit first before we start doing anything or talking about anything. Because if it had not been for Him, where would we be? If it had not been for the things that He has been doing for us, where would we be? So I make sure I give God His credit. Like I said a little while back, we give credit to where stuff that, you know, somebody or some makeup artist or whoever clothes or whatever we're doing. But make sure you give God that, because if it wasn't for Him, you wouldn't have that talent that you have. You wouldn't have those, the love that people are showing you. You wouldn't have that if it wasn't for Him. He's just that type of awesome God that make sure you give Him His credit first before you do anything else. I pray everyone is staying safe and you're staying, staying positive. And I'm grateful to God for allowing you to be a part of God's day along with me. Anything that you do, share, come on and be a part of our podcast or a part of our lives. We appreciate you. Those that are on the podcast, we appreciate you for tuning in, downloading episodes, listening in your free time. We appreciate that. Continue to show love. We appreciate that, y'all, for everything you do with God's day, making comments, all that good stuff. So I'm grateful to God for just for you and being a part of what God's day is doing. Of course, we're doing more things. Of course, it takes time to get things going like you want it. But I just wanted to make sure that we are staying safe and not letting all the things that's going on change us or change us from who we are. You know, we get complacent. We allow, you know, we want to be in the mix. We want to be in the crowd. So we'll go with what the crowd is doing, and we don't have our own mind. We're going with the crowd. Instead of being a leader, we're being followers. And God don't want us to be followers of anybody else but Him. And that's a lot of times that's what we do. We go with the in crowd. We go with the person that got the most followers, the most likes, the most beautiful pictures or whatever, most posts or whatever the case may be. And we're following the wrong crowd. Are you following the right crowd? What crowd are you following? Is it a positive crowd? Is it a crowd just to get likes? Is it a crowd just to be seen? What kind of crowd are you following? And I think my husband preaches a message on that, about the crowd that we follow. You know, when before they was hollering out Hosanna, you know, to Jesus or whatever, Hosanna, they were laying palm trees on the ground, and they're allowing, because they didn't want the hooves to hit the ground, and they going through all of this. And then the following week, that same crowd, now they talking about crucifying. What crowd are you with? Are you with the crowd that's positive and keeping you encouraged and keeping you up? Are you with that crowd that's just going to keep pulling you down and they just want you to do, go by things they want you to go by? What crowd are you following? Or you have your own crowd that you're the leader of. You being the leader of, you not allowing somebody else to lead your crowd. What crowd are you following? Are you following a crowd that does not mind being helpful to you? We talked about being helpful, being a helpful neighbor on yesterday. Are you a crowd that follows, or are you a crowd that leads positive influences on other people, or you a crowd that just go with just whatever it is. Oh, I'm cool with that. That's fine. We can just do it that way. That's all right with me. I don't mind. That's cool. Instead of speaking up and saying, you know what, that's not good. Sometimes the best thing to do, even though folks may feel like you hard or you got it all together, you still have to remember that, you know, all things that seem like it should be a bad situation, you don't have to leave it as a bad situation. It can become something good. It can become something great if you change it around. But if you accepting whatever the crowd is accepting, if you going out there and you just going with what's being said or what's being done, are you a leader or are you a follower? Do you do things that make someone want to be to see you as a role model, or are you following what everybody else is just going with? Everybody is not a role model. Everybody is not for you to follow. Everybody is not for you to be in a partner. We got some people that follow people that are just not good people. They want to be on that bad side. They want to accept the bad things, or they want to accept those things that that's not going to get them anywhere. Some people are just comfortable with that type of lifestyle or comfortable with those type of things. What crowd are you following? Who are you? What are you doing to be better? You're going to continue to be a follower. You've been a follower all your life, and you have never led. Don't be afraid. I told you a while back, or I think even yesterday, to step out there. Don't be afraid to be a leader. If you got to lead your own situation, your own things. But learning how to be a leader comes with a whole lot of things. A lot of people don't want to because they feel like there's some people are just afraid to step out. But it's time about to stop hiding behind somebody else, or being the person that you want to do it, but you just stepping, leaning back, you staying back because you're afraid. Step out there. Don't be afraid to step out there. Don't be afraid to be a leader. Don't always have to follow behind somebody else. It's okay to speak up and add your input in, and wanting to be more of a leader. Leading is not bad, but you got to know how to become a leader. We got a lot of leaders that need to learn how to be followers. You can't even be a follower. How you gonna be a leader and you don't know how to be a follower? A lot of people don't know how to do that. They want to own everything. They want to be in charge of everything, but they don't even know how to follow. They talk crazy to people, talk bad to people, and they want everybody to follow to their beat of their drum, but they don't know how to follow to their own beat of somebody else's drum. They don't know how. God say, y'all, okay, I'm sorry, y'all. I'm hungry now.
Good morning, man.
Is that my jacket you have on? I do not have on your jacket. God's day. And by the way, let me do a pause for the calls right there. I'm glad you brought that up. This earring set is my sister, so I don't know where she got it from, but we wearing it today. But that's my sister that got this set from. But the jacket is Boss Bae's Boutique. You can go to them. I follow them on Instagram. You can go to them if you want my promo code. You can just let me know. But I have posted this a while back. This is my first time wearing a jacket. So this is Boss Bae's Boutique. Again, they're on Instagram. They may be on Facebook. But I am a brand ambassador for them. So if you want a promo code just to see if they have some more, I got this a while back. It wasn't no need to be wearing jackets and stuff like at the time I got it. So, okay. So again, this jacket is Boss Bae's Boutique. On Instagram, you can follow them. If you need my promo code, I can give you my promo code for a discount on any other items. It don't have to be this jacket, but it can be any other items. So that's that. Y'all know I'm gonna tell y'all to follow people. Miss Tracy Green with BWA, The Stylish Way. She did a wig live on yesterday. If it's still up, go back and look at the live. She had some really good deals on yesterday. She had $20 wigs, and she's got a new inventory coming in. As well as she sells earrings, necklaces, everything you need from the top of your head to the sole of your feet. So whatever it is that you need from Miss Tracy Green, BWA, The Stylish Way, her information is on the GodStay81.com website. Please go to GodStay81.com, click on the advertisements page. There is information and new information that is there that I've updated as of this week. You can go and see new businesses that are there, new information. I've been posting job information. So again, if y'all know of anybody that's doing hiring, or you're hiring, or you're looking for a job, please send me the information to godstay81@gmail.com and let us see what we can do about finding that. Even those that may be in need of assistance with utility bills or with their rent, I know a lot of people are still not working. I know a lot of people still are trying to do little different things to make sure that they or family are good. Guys, they whisper. But please let me know. If you know of a job fair, you know of a particular company that is hiring, let's get the information out there to other people so they can find. It doesn't matter what state or city that you're in. Let's just make sure that we are being helpful and giving out these resources. If you're in church or your community is giving away food, having a food drive or whatever that would be helpful to others. Maybe somebody needs to have food. And I know a lot of people are not doing it, and some are because of COVID. But anyway, let's make sure that we're getting that information out. So again, if your church is giving away food, your community, your job, anything, any information you have that could be helpful to somebody, you're giving away something yourself. You, hey, I got a bag of clothes, I'm trying to get this away. Let's help each other out. There's a lot out here we could be doing positive to make sure that everybody is doing good and they stand on the up and up. Because you're not going through it, because you're not dealing with it, does not mean that somebody does not need that assistance. Because your life is going good, your health is fine, does not mean that your sister or your brother does not need that help or does not need resources to assist them in what they're needing. You can be helpful. You can be helpful to somebody else. It doesn't have to always come in the form of money. It can come in the form of, hey, I got some information that you can use. Hey, I got some stuff, some food. I got some clothes. I got something over here that you can use, or maybe you know somebody that can. Maybe somebody have multiple kids and they can't provide clothes for everybody, or they can't provide food for them. You got the resources. That's you being helpful. Yeah, you know what a blessing that would be. Again, it doesn't mean you're going to be blessed with money, but you not to get this virus. There are people around you that's getting it and not you. God's been good to you. Be helpful. Don't go to the store and take all of the stuff at the store. Everybody needs tissue. Everybody wants paper towel. Everybody needs some dishwashing liquid. They need all of these things. Don't go and buy it all. If you're not going to give it away or help another family or help somebody else out, don't just go to the store and buy it all and be greedy. We are not supposed to be greedy, okay? So when you go to, if you're going and you say, hey, I'm just going to buy all of this because I want to help other families, I want to assist with making sure that other families have what they need, just in case. I know they're not talking about shutdown. Then again, they talk about shutdown. I don't know what they're doing. But in the event, we still need these particular items. So don't be greedy and go and buy it all up and then keep it off in your closet and you're not helping somebody else. Hey, help somebody. If you know a sale, I know a few people they post about, hey, y'all, they got this over here. Y'all looking for Lysol? They'll take a picture and say, this is where I was. Y'all can come over here and get y'all some Lysol. Whatever the case may be. Be of assistance to somebody else. Don't always feel like all of these things you got to hoard and have just for you and your family. Everybody else wants to. Again, we all need tissue. We all need tissue. So, and we all have to use it. So with that being said, don't go to the store and just buy it up because you feel like that's something that you should do. Be nice to your neighbor. Be nice to everybody else. Listen, this is how you can lead out. If you're telling somebody, if you're one of those ones, you can tell somebody, hey, let's not do that. Let's help somebody. You know, we know some people that could use this. Let's help them. Let's send them. Let's see if they can use it. Now, everybody probably won't accept your help. That's not your fault if they don't accept your help. Let them figure it out. Then say, hey, I was thinking about you. I got little extra things of tissue, or I got some extra boxes of food. I was wondering, do you want it? And if they say no, okay, move on to the next. Don't even worry about it. Don't sweat. They didn't accept my food. Child, somebody will. There's some other people out here that are hungry. As I stated the other day, there are people, these kids don't get a chance to eat until they go to school. And the way school has been closed and they've been limited to a whole lot of stuff, these kids are not eating every day, or they're not eating as much as they should. One meal a day or a small meal a day. So don't get upset about that. I think we was having a conversation where they was talking about it at work. All this food we've thrown away, and there's people out here hungry. And I was shaking my head. I was like, yeah, that is true, because there are a lot of kids or a lot of people that are out here hungry, and we're just, you know, we got too much, so we just throw it away instead of, we shouldn't have got all of it in the first place. If you don't need it, don't go get it. If you don't, if it's not something that you can use, leave it alone. Let somebody that is less fortunate than you, that can accept that those resources or those needs, instead of you going to go get it and hoarding it and not even using it, and you could allow some other family to have it. So let's make sure that we, again, being helpful to our families or to somebody else. Again, it's always somebody in need. They may not need food. They may not need clothes. They may need other resources, a job. That's why I'm telling y'all about jobs, and if you have information on getting a job, just let me know. Again, guysday81@gmail.com. guysday81@gmail.com. Send me that information. If you want to be a guest on the podcast, please email me at guysday81@gmail.com. Again, it's guysday81@gmail.com. And let's be helpful and resourceful to other people that may be in need. And you don't know. Like I said yesterday, one situation can change your life. And you may be sitting where this person is. You may be going through with the same way this person is going through, where they're in need. You never know. So don't treat people how you want to be treated. I believe that's the golden rule. You want to be treated fairly. You want to be treated right. You treat people the same exact way. As I was saying a few minutes ago, with being a leader, you have to learn how to treat people by being a great leader as well. If you don't know how to follow, hey, how are you, guys? Say whisper. If you don't know how to follow, how are you going to become a leader? You can't be the head of the class. And I mean, I'm saying head of the class, and I mean like manager, supervisor, owner. I don't care what you do. You cannot be in leadership and be mean and ornery to people and talk to people any kind of way and cuss at folks. The same delivery you give to people, you do know that's the delivery you're going to get back. In order to gain respect, you got to give respect. You can't talk to people crazy and think that you're going to get results. You're not. And this day and time, folks is quick to snap back at you and tell you, oh, you ain't going to talk to me like that. Exactly. You because you own a business does not mean you can talk to people any kind of way. Hey guys, say whisper, how are you? Because you own a business does not mean you can talk to people crazy. Respect people. You want your employees to respect you. You want your employees to do what you're asking them to do, to follow protocol, to do all of those things. In order for them to do all of those things, they have to see that same drive, that same energy, that same love that you want. They want to see it from you. They have to see it from you in order for them to do it. They are what their leader is. If their leader is sorry and lazy and don't want to do anything, what you think they going to do? Well, my boss do it. My supervisor do it. What you think they going to do? Don't talk to people crazy because you feel like, oh, you need me. Don't have that I need you, because, again, one situation can change your whole life around. One situation, one thing can change your whole life to where you don't even get a chance to that what you thought you had a great business or a big business or whatever. One situation can change that, because you can't talk to people crazy and think you're going to get great results. You will not. That does not work like that. Y'all hold on just a second. Let me, y'all know what this is. my voice, they pull up a little bit more. But you have, in order to get those type of respect, you're going to have to give it yourself. You don't, because you own this big time company or you just starting out and you need employees, don't talk down to people. Don't pull people down beneath you. And you need people. Don't, and even if you didn't need people, you don't talk to people crazy and won't respect. Hold on a second. Let me go and tell them this. Yes, can I have the hot case and sausage? The sausage well done. And let me have a parfait.
What if I
have
any more parfait now?
Oh, okay. Okay, that's fine.
Only a hot thing without it?
Yes, please. Thank you. So anyway, a good leader is a good follower and leads. Exactly. Thank you, Miss Kristen. You are absolutely correct. For those that's on the podcast, Miss Kristen said a good leader is a good follower and leads by example. Exactly. In order for you to get, okay, I think you next. I don't know. Go ahead, baby, though. We gonna, I don't know. These two lanes, they, I don't know, but we'll find out when we get up here. They'll figure it out. But a great, you have to be in order. You have to be a great follower. If you can't come in not knowing anything about a job or a business or anything, and come in and just be at the head of it, just know how to do everything. And you talking to folks crazy, you doing it whatever you want to, you not doing what you're supposed to be doing, and then you have and then you thinking you got it going on, but you have not followed anybody. You haven't been an entry level, and you learn how to respect the people, to learn how to talk to people, to learn the job yourself, to learn how to be an entry level person. You can't come in thinking you're gonna be the manager and you don't know anything. We got a lot of managers that, you know, and I'm not, you know, talking about all over. We got a lot of managers that that shouldn't be in leadership position because they don't know how to be a follower. You get this position, we let those positions get to our head, and we let our own this and I run this and I do that. We let that get to our heads, and we don't realize, why don't you have nobody supporting you? Why don't you have nobody want to be a part of your team or be a part to work with you? You don't, and when you start having people scattering everywhere, you can't keep employee turnaround. It's horrible. That means there's something that needs to be changed in management. That means that something needs to be changed in owners. That means there's change that needs to be done all the way around. Go back to the beginning and scrub and rub until you get things right that are in order. We are at this point where positions matter to us, titles matter to us, and it's really not that's matter. Okay, that matters. You can let anybody be in charge of stuff. You can let anybody, but do they know what they're doing? Do they know how to constructive criticism? Do they know how to accept when they're wrong? Do they know how to speak up and say, I was wrong? Do you defend your employees? Do you defend your business? Do you let somebody come in and just talk down about your business or your employees or talk down about your job? What are you doing? See, that's leadership, to where you showing people how to be in charge. All this stuff, you being a part of mess, you being in mess, you got mess, it's too much. It's too much. And if you are that person, sometimes, again, we have to go back to the beginning and we have to reevaluate our own selves, because we're so used to just letting things go the way. We used to everybody telling us yes. When we don't accept no no's, because we feel like we're right. We always got it. I'm always right. It got to be my way, or there's not going to be another way. Really? I've seen people business go down to nothing because of that. Hold on, y'all.
Yeah.
Yes. Thank you. They do know the sausages is the only thing that's well done, right?
I'm sorry?
I said they do know the sausages is the only thing well done, right?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I don't want the pancakes well done. Thank you. You too. So anyway, you don't, people feel like that. Oh, I'm in leadership, so it got to go my way. Oh, I'm in leadership, they wrong, and they don't. And you just like, who made you manager? Who made you in charge? Because you feel like what you saying is the right or the correct thing. That does not always mean it. Does not mean that's the way that it's supposed to go. Learn how to listen to your employees. Learn how to listen to somebody else. You don't know everything. Nobody knows everything. And if you knew everything, you wouldn't be in the position that you're in. You wouldn't be asking questions. You would have it all the way together.
Okay.
Yes. She gave me this bag like she ain't put no syrup in there, ma'am. I'm gonna need you to put that in there. So anyway, don't think because you're in that type of position. Now again, I'm not talking to people that already do this or that's not an issue for you. I'm talking to those that feel like because you are a manager or a supervisor or because you run a company, does not mean you get to talk to people crazy and you get great results. You will get out what you put out, okay? It's just like you planting something. When you plant something, what you put in the ground, that's what's going to come out. If you didn't plant that particular thing in the ground, it does not come out. So learning how to talk to, because I see a lot of people, they feel like you. And that's why I told y'all a long time, last week, I believe, we talked about how folks bully you to use them or bully you to buy something from them. Don't ever get bullied by a company, by anybody, to buy that. Your customer service is horrible, or I don't like what you said, or I don't like how you deal with things. Don't take things because you have this position or you have this title. Titles is going to send a lot of people to hell. I mean, really. I mean, this goes for, this not just jobs. This is any leadership. Church, home, schooling, any of those things. It goes all the way around. You see a whole lot of people that don't really understand. We don't want to take no classes. We don't want to sit down nowhere and take any classes. Some people in leadership and management in the workplace and in church have no business being in management, in a management position, have no people skills, no compassion, and school favoritism. And show favoritism. You are absolutely correct, Miss Kristen. I'm trying not to say... Listen, folks think, I mean, this fussing and cussing and you, like you with the Hulk and stuff, it's too much, like you're doing too much. I feel like we need to go back to the basic of, and I know with COVID going on, there's a lot of things that are on social media or online that you can go back and you can watch different tutorials and stuff to teach you how to be of a better person. This is not okay because of your title. Oh, I'm the manager, so it got to go my way. Oh, I do this, so it got to be. And that's not the case. That's not the way things should be. We need to humble ourselves from a whole lot of things, not just this, but a whole lot of things we need to humble ourselves for, because we feeling like I'm in this position and it got to go my way. And that's not fair to somebody that's coming in behind you. And people think that that's management. Our folks are, oh, they're going to let them be a manager. No, where's your golden rule we was taught when we was in Sunday school, when we was little in Sunday school? The golden rule: treat others how you want to be treated. If I don't care what your title is, you still got to be humble and be nice to people. Don't talk to people any kind of way. Don't feel like you can't listen to your employees. Most of the time, 98% of the time, your employees know more than you. 98% of the time, and this is just me. This is just my statistic scale. 98% of the time, your employees know more than you do, because you came in off of the street, or you came in from anywhere, and you just became a manager because you went to school, because you have a degree. That does not mean that. What kind of people skills do you have? What kind of social skills do you have? What kinds of I'm trying to remember what I was trying to say with that. But what kind of skills do you have? And it doesn't have to be with the actual work. It got to be with how you're treating people, how you expect for your employer. Because if you came in and you worked at that same position, you in the same position as your employees are, or you being an owner or whatever, you in that same position as them, would you want your boss to talk to you or come to you like that? Would you want them to just say what they want to you? Would you want them to do that to you? Well, don't treat nobody else like that. If you don't want to be treated and said to like that, learn some new skills. Listen to your employees. They know more. Especially if they've been there longer than you, because they're not in management position don't mean they don't know. Folks to get that misunderstood. Well, you've been here 25. Well, you've been here one and you still wrong. And because you say it says manager, supervisor, boss, whatever you want to call yourself, that don't mean you know it all. That doesn't mean that's the way that things are supposed to go. I will always say this. Look at how, since you've been in your position, since you've been an owner, since you've been in charge of whatever, look how people are grabs hold to you or want to be a part of what you got going on. If they don't, it's you. I said it. Yes, I did. It's you. If you can't keep people, you got to turn around. You can't, every time you do something, you got to get somebody new to do it or different to do it. You can't, they keep leaving or they not want to be a part of it. It's you. Change you. It's something about you. Self-evaluation. That's not, people are not drawn to. And I'm not saying people got to draw to you, but if you're talking about a business, I don't care. I love the fact the way Miss Tracy handled her business. She said, I love y'all, but it's my business. I cannot just let you just come in and do whatever you want to in my business. She said, I'm telling y'all. She said, you know I love you. And you know, God, he loves you too. But I cannot allow you to do what you want to in my business. I cannot allow things to go on. She said, we friends or whatever. I could do whatever I got. But what I can't do is allow you to just do what you want to in my business. So, it's okay to, if it's your friends and they don't like how you handle your business, maybe you need to find somebody else that can do what you're needing. That bullying, you forcing me, you making me, you talking crazy to me, you get no results. You don't get far with that. You cussing at, let me tell you something about me. If you holler at me, this just me, this is personally me. If you holler at me, cuss at me, or you get loud with me, I'm somebody else, okay? Can't come at me like that. Oh, and grabbing her. Like you coming and you talking with your hands and you close to me. I can't deal. It's too much. Okay? So I just feel like my favorite little spots, they already don't got them. Let's see. It's fine. I'll just do this. But all of those things are being done. We're going to have to, that's why I said, even with our business, if you see that that's you, you've been in business 2, 3, 4 years or whatever, and you feel like you have, things have been, you just looking back and like, oh my gosh, how many people have came through here? How many people have I hired? How many people haven't stayed? Look at yourself and make sure that you got your business in order. How is your conversation with people? Do you have to be the person that have to be in a crowd in order for you to talk to an employee? If you got a situation with somebody, do you pull them off to the side, take them in a conference room or to the, you know, away from people and have whatever conversation you need to have with them and then, you know, get that on? Or do you have to say, no, you should have done this and you all out above? If you're the person that's, no, you should have did it this when you screaming and hollering at people, it's you. You're the person. Change that. Don't have a one-on-one conversation with 25 other people. Now it's not a one-on-one. That's 26. It's you and those other 25 people. People don't accept that well. Oh, you got to have a crowd. If you're that person, it's you. Change you. If you got to get on live and dog people out and talk crazy to them and say what they didn't do and what they was, and they work for you or they working with you or they doing something for you, change you. Okay? That's you. You can't keep nobody. You can't dog people out and expect great results. Like, I'm trying to help somebody that may not understand. This is you. If you can't keep people, you got stuff always going on. You involved in mess. Your name is always come up. You don't see where you supporting. Your posting is horrible. Let me see what you said. Just because you're a preacher does not mean you are called to be a pastor of a church. Listen, ma'am, I gotta go. I can't do this with you today. I even get to read the whole thing. Just because you're a preacher does not mean you are called to be a pastor of a church. And just because you are a good worker or know people in the company does not qualify you or equip you to be in leadership. You don't say it a whole mouthful. You don't say it a whole mouthful. People feel like, oh, I can preach. I should be a pastor of a church. You do not. Okay. You have to be called. And because you are called to preach does not mean you're being called to pastor. Pastoring is different from preaching. Have you ever said, yeah, we're looking for a preacher? A preacher means I just need you to come over and preach, do what we say, and go on about your business. Pastoring means I want you to run things from beginning to the end. You are in charge. You, whatever you say, we got to do it. Whatever is going on, whatever decisions you make, you're in charge. That's the difference. Management, that means you know you can accept people telling you things when you have done something wrong. You know how to talk to people when you have how to talk to them off the floor, away from others, away from, you know, and learning how to get in there and actually work. Don't just sit there and delegate. You get in there and you work too. If your team is having a hard time, they haven't going through some stuff, you're supposed to step in and say, hey, I got this. Hey, I got that. Even if you're the owner. If you own a business, you see that there needs to be some stuff that needs to be taken care of. You're trying to help you step in and you help your employees out. You don't sit back and watch them. Let me see what they're going to do. No, you step in and you help out. Why are you going to let that's your business. You're going to let your business suffer because you want to see if your employees got it. How they going to care if you don't care? How you want your employees to be a part of what you got going on if you don't even care? If you don't even see the needs to care about your business, they gonna let your business sink because it's not their business, it's yours. So what you gonna do about it? You gonna step in, step up, and help your fellow brother or sister out? Or you gonna sit there and watch them fail? And that means your business fail. That means you fail. Okay? In order for you not to fall, you not to be a part of that failure rate that your company has been having, step up and change that. Take some training. Take some courses. Watch how you treat people. Because your name is on paperwork and you got all this going on, don't mean it's always you got it going on. Okay? There's still some things that we all need to learn, including myself. I'm not throwing myself out the mix and saying, oh, I don't need to learn nothing new or I got it all together. I do not. So I don't mind learning something new. I told you, I challenge myself every day. Every single day, I challenge myself, whether it's work, whether it's home, whether it's church, whatever. I challenge myself with something new every day. Because I know what type of person that I am. I know what I want out of life. I know what my goal is or what I'm trying to do. And in order for me to do that, I have to better myself. I have to look at things all the way around. We just cannot think that because we are in leadership or because we own things, that's the way things got to go. I told you, it takes one small situation to change your whole life. One small incident to change your whole life. Watch how you talk to people. Watch how you treat people. Humble yourself from all this big time I got it going on situation to let me just go back and look at some things and reevaluate me. Let's go back and let's find out what's going on, because all the time you thinking it because the money is coming in doesn't mean that that's the way life is supposed to be. again, changes. And God watches. He's sitting high and he's looking low. And he see every little bitty thing that we do, even when we're trying to hide and we're trying to shuck and jive him. I had to use that. That sounds like a Color Purple word. We're trying to shuck and jive him. He's looking and he's paying attention to everything that we're doing. Are we bettering ourselves? Are we doing, we looking for more? Are we trying to do more? Many are called, few are chosen. And a lot of these people have ministries and have no business having a church. They have ran so many away from the church. Absolutely. Because we don't know how to let things go. We still hold on to stuff. And I told y'all, I guess I'm different. Because I see, you just be like, I just got the, you keep learning as you go. And you do. This we're all learning. Nobody knows everything. There's no perfect person. And because we're all learning something, that's okay to correct yourself. That's why I said, if y'all go to my website and y'all see something that y'all think I can do better, I accept the constructive criticism, because I don't mind changing things to better the website or to better me. I don't have a problem with doing that. A lot of people feel like, oh, don't tell me about my stuff. This the way I wanted it. Okay, that's fine. But again, we don't know everything. We're learning. We help each other out. Back to being helpful. Back to being resourceful to your brother or your sister. Back to helping anybody that needs assistance, you helping them out. And you can't do that with the mean, the honoring, the attitude. Ooh, these attitudes are so stanky. Ooh, they are. They are horrible because we feel like we in charge. My attitude don't have to be good. Oh, okay. People will show you better than they will tell you. Keep treating people wrong. They gonna show you, but they gonna leave you high and dry. They gonna hurt your feelings. So be careful how you treating people, because it's not all fun and game. Listen, it's not all fun and game. So be careful about how you treating people. Anyway, I'm gonna go. I want y'all to go back and listen to the podcast episodes. The podcast, the link will be attached to this video. Okay. Let me close this water, because I was finna get out. The wind don't took over. Listen, the podcast, God Say Podcast, is on all your podcast media platforms. I will attach the link to this video, and all you have to do is click on the link and start downloading your episodes. We've been doing podcasting since February, I believe. So there are a lot of episodes, and I still have more to upload. But go ahead and you can start listening to those. Now, we do have lives that we done as early as last year. They're on our YouTube channel, which is Whispers in the Pews. You can go back and listen to the early stages of God's Day, when we was talking about true friends, and we had some great conversation. We were bringing people in on the camera, on live, and we were having different people come in and talk and being a part of that. So you can go back and watch those on YouTube. Subscribe to the YouTube channel, which is Whispers in the Pews, as well as our God's Day podcast. Follow us on Facebook, which is God's Day. Instagram, Twitter, Pinterest, and I told you about YouTube. And you can email us at godsday81@gmail.com. godsday81@gmail.com. You have any resourceful information, nonprofit organization, your business information, your church information, you can send me that information, and we'll put it on a godsday81.com website and allow others to come and support you and be there for you and whatever you have going on, even with your events. We could post that information and let others see what you have going. So that's that. Also, when you go to the website, if you have not already signed up to be an email subscriber, please be an email subscriber today. I will be doing a drawing here probably tomorrow. We're going to see. For those only for the email subscribers. So if you're not a part of that list, I will not be adding you on to receive a gift or whatever. It may do a couple of them. We'll see. So make sure that you're going in. For those that are on the podcast, please go to God's Day on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Pinterest, and also on YouTube. Thank y'all for following me. Thank y'all for being a part of what God's Day is doing. Thank y'all for anything that is accepted. You have a topic that y'all want to talk about. You have products, or you have a business that you would like me to talk about. Send me that information at godsday81.com. godsday81@gmail.com. Forgive me. godsday81@gmail.com. As I stated before, this jacket is from Boss Base Boutique. They're on Instagram, Boss Base Boutique. And I'm a brand ambassador for them. So this is a jacket that I got from them, and I can give you my promo code if you would like to have a discount when you order something from them. But follow them on Instagram. If you missed the beginning of the live, go back and listen in. You keep learning. Okay, I seen it. It's all about the approach and the delivery of the criticism. Listen, because people come to you, you need to change this, you need to do that. No. And what you saying that we need to learn, and I'm saying we because I'm putting myself into it. A lot of people include. We need to learn how to be approachable. A lot of people are not approachable to where you can come to them and talk to them. They have to have people with them in order to deliver a message because you are not approachable. We should all be approachable so anybody can come up to you and have a conversation with you, tell you what you're doing wrong, accept what they're telling you. Let that be. Whatever somebody comes to you and tell you something about you and how you can better yourself, accept it. Don't come with an attitude. Don't give them no attitude where you shouldn't. We'll be barking for the barking. Let's cease that. This is how we can be better. Except you might not like what's being said, but how can you be better if you know if you're never wrong? Oh, because you think you're always right. No, you're not. You're not always right. I got to get out of here, y'all. You're not always right. We got to do better with that. Again, Miss Tracy Green, BWA, The Stylish Way. Check her out. She's on my guysday81.com website. Under advertisements. I changed it from announcements to advertisements. So click on that and you will see her information. A Soft Answer Turns Away Rap. Listen, you finna start preaching today. You about to start preaching. Okay, listen, you about to start preaching. I'm just saying, folks don't understand that. They feel like what they way is the right way, and I'm not never wrong. Yes, you are. You have not. We got to stop thinking we always do things right and we're always right. No, we not. We got issues with a whole lot of other things, but we don't want to talk about it because we feel like we are this perfect person or we are this perfect people. We are not perfect. We are not perfect. We are a long way from being perfect. And if you perfect, what you here for? That means you God. And I know you ain't him. That means you him if you saying you're perfect. You a lie. Okay, I'm sorry. I don't need to say it like that. But you're not perfect. Let's straighten up. Let's get ourselves together. Know that God is watching everything that you're doing. He's looking at every little bit of thing. The things you think you hide and keeping away, He's watching. Hold your head up. Keep staying there. Hold on to God. Don't ever switch it, because He don't switch up on us. Don't ever switch up on Him. He got your back when nobody else does, when nobody else answers the phone. God got your back. He supports you. He's there for you. He watching your back. He watching where you slumber and sleep. He watching you as you drive up and down these dangerous highways. He watching you in everything that you do. He's taking care of you. Don't be afraid to say, God been watching me. He been taking care of me. Don't wait till you need Him. I heard a radio personality say yesterday, it's a shame that we're not been saying this, but I guess it takes us, you know, somebody on the radio to say it. I've been saying this. It takes us to realize that we need God when we in trouble. It's sad that we have to wait till we go through something or we in something in order for us to realize that we need God. And then it's too, just like you, is it real? Because you should have been needing and praising Him in season and out of season. When you feel Him and when you don't. When you're going through and when you're not. When everything is perfect and when it's not. That's when you're supposed to be praising God. Don't wait till you're going through. Don't wait till you get sick. Don't wait till you get down and out. Don't wait till your finances change. And then you need God. And then the crazy part of it is, it's flipped around the other way. Once I got everything that I need from God, He done gave me what I've been asking for all this time. Everything I've been looking for all this time. I don't need God no more. Thank you, God. I'm gone. That's what people do to Him. That's what folks do. And we don't realize it until you just like, I did God like that. And then you some people don't even realize it. They accept what's been sent out there. Whatever has been said, that's what they go with. Instead of them realizing, God, I needed you this whole entire time. You never left me nor forsake me. You never gave up on me. When folks turned their back on me, you was there. When I was going through my little situation, you was there. Miss Tracy Green, BWA, Stylish Way. Okay? All right. Miss Tracy Green, BWA, The Stylish Way. Check her out. GuysDay81.com. Click on announcements. You're going to see some other good stuff, some other good businesses that are there. You want to be one of those businesses? Email me. Let me go around, y'all. Give my stuff. But email me. Send me your information. You got a product. You want me to talk about it? Send me the information. Let's talk about it.
I'll be trying to get out the car. But don't forget about the things that I said today. Again, y'all can always go back and listen to our podcast episodes on your favorite podcast platforms. They are available now. You can download and listen to. If you Google God's Day, you will see everything that God's Day is a part of. I try to post and keep y'all informed as much as I know about things that's going on. But if you Google God's Day, just type in God's Day, you'll see how much information that God's Day is a part of our podcasting, our email address, our website, our posting, all of that. You Google God's Day, it's there. But again, I'm going to attach the information here anyway so that you can just click on it. It's very accessible. You don't have to go and browse around and look around. I have it much accessible to you. So you just do one click and there's the information there for you to download and use and listen to. And following us on Instagram and Twitter, Facebook as well. Go like our Facebook page, God's Day, if you have not already. Again, all this information is accessible to you with one click. And again, I will post that once I end this live. I will post that information. Stay in your lane and grow where you're planted. Listen, we use God like a sugar daddy. Listen, ma'am, we use God like a sugar daddy. Once you need him, then you get him. Listen, you said that. I'm a minister at my church. Listen, a lot of people don't want to do that. Miss Kristen, you're going to start with something. Now I'm about to come back with this again because you don't start at something. A lot of people don't like to hear that. It bothers me that people don't like to accept constructive criticism, don't feel like they can do better. They think they found where they are. We can all do better with something. We can all increase our life better with something. And we feel like we don't because we good. And that's not always the case. So. Whew. You're welcome. But we all can do better with something. We feel like we are good where we are, but we can always do better than what we've been doing. And we need to do better. Stop saying where we are. Learn how to treat people. And you go and treating God like a sugar daddy. You don't say something. Listen, we do like to treat him like a sugar daddy. When we done with him, we make him go on by his business. We don't even care no more. We don't got what we needed from him. Hey, God, bye, God. I'm done. What? Oh, okay. Good morning. Good morning. He can show you better than he can tell you. I promise you he can. He can definitely show you better than he can tell you. Throw him away when you back and forth. Pick him up like he a toy. Keep doing that to him. He gonna have a different news for you. He got different news for you. All right, y'all, I gotta go. Enjoy the rest of y'all's day. Stay humble. Humble yourself. Self-evaluate you. Think about the things that I said. If you missed it, go back to the beginning. And listen in. Download the podcast episode. Follow us on all social media platforms. Have a great rest of your day. God loves you. He wants you to do better. He wants us to be more than what we have been.
Good morning. don't know.
You know what I mean?
No, when you go and find it, there's a winter and a summer. There's two lines on there. See, only two.
But if they only have the
But they had two. They had a 19 and a 20. They had the last winter and this summer. She took one and divided it into two and missed the whole other thing. It was like 5,100 instead of 3,000.
One more 21 in the gym.
They working on.
Give them, said they already got